All right, good morning, contractors. Brian Adams here, the Contractor's Contractor. In this video, I'm going to share and talk about you are interviewing the homeowner more than they are interviewing you. Hey, yesterday I shared this video, went online and talked with my private group for contractors only. And it was just that. The homeowner is not interviewing you, you're interviewing the homeowner. And that came about because I get the question quite a bit, but I got it like from two different contractors in the same day. Brian, how do you handle asshole homeowners? How do you deal with homeowners that aren't nice or whatever? And I'm like, you don't. Quit working for them people. Man, the best thing about working for yourself is you get to choose who you're working for. Damn, brother, come on. So during the interview process, the bid, the estimate, when you're sending back and forth text messages, if you know any of my systems that I use, if you're sending back emails back and forth, you're asking questions, you're learning about them, I'm researching them on Facebook, I'm looking them up on Google, everything. I want to build an instant rapport, rapid rapport. I want to be friends with them as quickly as I can because we do business with people we know, like, and trust. Patrick, what's up, brother? Damn right, man. And trust me, I probably do it more than you guys, but over the years, there'd be two or three clients. And here's the thing, man, it's like women, and I know there's a lot of women contractors, so for women, it's probably like the guys that you're dating. But for us guys, I hear guys talking about, you see a guy that's with a girl and she's, you just thinking, man, what in the hell he's doing with her? And all the red flags are there. All the red flags are there. You keep ignoring them. When you go and meet with a client, whatever, I'm looking at their bumper stickers. I'm looking at things around their house, all kind of stuff. What channel do they have on? Watching the news when I go in, meet with them. And I don't go and give estimates because I'm not doing free estimates. We've already discussed all that crap. I'm going over to pick a deposit and measure up and just check everything out. But if you don't like them, don't work for them. I mean, the flags are there. And again, I'm saying this because, like I said, there'd be two or three clients I'd meet with them and they're assholes. And you can tell they're just either too picky, they're looking at this, or for whatever reason, the flags are there, but I'm thinking I can win them over. Me and my guys are so special, we're going to do such a great job, man, they're going to be happy, I'm going to be patting myself on the back. No. No, man, look, man, some people are only happy when they're making other people miserable. Get that. You can't make everybody happy. Stop trying. Don't work for these people. It ain't worth it, man. You're just gonna pull your hair out. You guys, just like myself, you've had homeowners call you and they've had to get rid of a contractor and they're looking for someone to finish the job. Now, I'm not knocking. I'm not, that's my first red flag, but I give them the benefit of the doubt because I know so many effing flaky contractors that don't do what they say they're going to do. They don't show up, but they'll get the material there, they'll start the job, something will happen supposedly, and they need to come back a week or two later. So it's a red flag, but I don't rule it out because there's so many bad contractors out there. But this whole short video is, don't work for people you don't like. Don't work for people that you know when you show up and the way that they talk and the way they carry a conversation is just, you get that sixth sense. Use it. God gave it to you for a reason. Use it, man. Because you get middle of the job and you're thinking, what in the hell am I doing here? And there's no way to get out of it. You got to bite your lip. You got to do whatever it is, and it ain't worth it. We work for ourselves because we get to choose who we work for. We get to choose our schedule. We get to choose our price. We get all of that stuff. And that's the number one thing you should be choosing, is who you're going to be spending time with. Because some of these projects, some of you guys, man, you're there 3 months, 6 months, longer. Some of you are in and out 2 or 3 days. But even at the end, they're picking things apart. They're going through this. They're doing that. I mean, it's, and you knew it from the beginning. So, hey, got no one to blame but yourself. When the red flags show up, walk away. Now, you, and that's the whole thing with all the videos that I'm doing, with all the training I give you guys, is you've got to have so many leads coming in. You got to have the phone ringing so much and the emails coming in asking for your services that you get to pick and choose the people that you work for. Because when you get behind the eight ball and you haven't worked in 2 or 3 days or a week, and an asshole client calls you up and you've got all the red flags and you know you shouldn't, you don't want anything to do with them. If you wouldn't sit down and have a beer with them, don't do work for them. That's the way I plan it. If I don't want to hang out with them afterwards, I don't want to work for them. But when you haven't worked and that's the only fish you have on the line, you got to reel it in, you know, whether you want to or not. And that's the one, you know, you have to take the job. And again, you start telling yourself, well, I'll slow everything. You know, I'll make it work, man. I can win them over. And no, you can't. They're just miserable people wanting to make other people miserable. Patrick said, some people won't be happy when they get to heaven. And that's true, brother. It's like, man, when I do events sometimes and I say that, and I'll say, hey, raise your hand if you know people who, they're only happy when they're making other people miserable. Raise your hand up high. Let me know some people that you know it. And I say, look around at the people who don't have their hand raised. That's because they're the one making people miserable. All right. But yeah, so stay busy. Keep the phone ringing. Do all the lead generation. You know, mine is, you know, Google AdWords and Facebook. I'm getting ready to do a video in a couple of minutes. I'm going to go live. Talk about marketing 101. But Andrew, what's up, brother? But yeah, so if stay busy, you have your own business, hopefully, you know, my definition is, if you have to be there, it's not a business, it's a job. But man, it's like, that's the best thing about working for yourself is you get to hang, you know, you get to do the jobs that you want to do. You get to hang around with the people that you want to hang around with. It's just like your employees. If you got a, you know, employee, they out, man. He's like, you surround yourself with people that you want to be around. And you're not going to let your, man, my employees are my everything. You got to know that. I treat them like that. And I'm not going to send them to someone's house who, that homeowner is a jerk and nitpicky and miserable to be around. It's like, I'm not going to subject my guys to that. Just ain't going to happen. So that's the lesson in this video. People ask me, Brian, how do you deal with difficult homeowners? I don't. Walk away. Run away. I've been there also, man. I've been behind the eight ball. You know, the guy's got to work. The phone's not ringing. You take jobs that you shouldn't. That's what I want you to get away from. I want you to have the phone ringing so much that you get to pick and choose and interview every homeowner before you work with them. All right, guys. Share the video. Leave me some love. Any questions, hit me up. I'll answer them. All right. Enjoy this Sunday. Thanks, guys.